today my lecture is about eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So first of all, why we use eigenvalues and eigenvectors in the linear algebra? So if you all know about the face recognition, and if you know about the example like differential equation, if system of differential equation you have to solve, there is 100 number of differential equation and 100 number of unknown variables. So you can solve by using the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So student, if you all know about the, if you all travel or many of you travel through the Sakhar bridge, so you all know what's happened. If you all are going on the way, then there is a simple harmonic motion or some vibration there. So this vibration is necessary for making the bridge. If you don't take the value of lambda, actual value of lambda, if you don't calculate the actual value of lambda, then the bridge will collapse. Or many of us news about that, sometimes the bridge has been collapsed in the past era, you know about this. So, and if you all know the picture and the selfie, if you all taken, then the picture rotation can be made through the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. And in biology, the DNA theory, you all know about the DNA structure can rotate, or the helical structure or the pentagon structure can be rotate by using this characteristic value of the lambda. So each picture has identical values, identical structure. Like if you all know about the Google search engine, the Google search engine is also based upon, the ranking of the Google search engine is based upon the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So this is very useful tool, or this useful application of eigenvalues and eigenvectors you can do. Or by using the population growth model, right now you all know about the census of 2017. Then how can we calculate the actual population growth model? Then this actual population growth model can be developed or can be find or can be predict by using the eigenvalues and eigenvector, because there's a number of equation or infinite solution can be made, or you can predict over the, you can say the planning and development, all the planning and development model can be created by using the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Like Markov matrix, if you know about the Markov matrix, like if I give you example of a infant of like baby, so we don't know when the baby is cry, when the baby is sleeping, these all are called steady states. Then these steady states are based upon the your Markov matrix, and this Markov matrix can be solved by using the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So it's clear? Now, if like in instrument, like in simple harmonic motion, as I told about, the frequency can calculated or can be determined, actual cos and sine values can be determined by the value of lambda. If anyone is using the jazz, or anyone using any type of music, then it can be determined by using the actual characteristic value of the lambda. Then the same frequency of the sound can be listened. And eigenvectors is based upon this basic equation of Ax is equal to lambda of x. Here lambda is a scalar quantity, and its value based upon this eigenvectors. If we determine the value of lambda, then we can find the eigenvectors, and every eigenvalues has eigenvectors. So if it is not necessary, then all eigenvectors are zero. Maybe on the value of if lambda is equal to 1, maybe one variable is 0, but not all values are 0. So we can say the value of Ax is equal to lambda x can be calculated by using the Ax is equal to 0. This is called your non-trivial solution, or you can say that singular matrix. So if we put Ax is equal to 0, then what's happened? Basically, this is based upon the theory of linear combination. In theory of linear combination, if this type of equation you have to find, like a11 x1 plus a12 x2 plus a13 and x3 plus a1n xn is equal to 0, It means there is some relation over the scalar quantity of A1, A2, A3 and so on. So by the using the matrix, if we have a 3 by 3 matrix, suppose we have a 3 by 3 matrix, then what's happened? Then if we write down the coefficient of A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32 and A33. This all eigen matrix is basically here, you know, the n by n matrix. It means it is a square matrix, and square matrix like 3 by 3 matrix if I take, then the eigen values can be calculated or over determinant of A minus lambda I is equal to 0. Here, what is the I? I is stand for your identity matrix. The identity matrix, if you take the 3 by 3 matrix, then lambda I will become lambda 0, 0. In the diagonal, you have the values only in the diagonals. So it's also called the diagonal matrix. This value is based upon lambda I. If I take the subtraction of A minus lambda I, then equation will become A11, only the diagonal values you have to determine by using the lambda. This is remains A12, A13, A21, A22 minus lambda, A23, A31, A32 and A33 minus of lambda. By solving determinant of this matrix is equal to 0, you can find the value of your lambda. So if there is 100 number of equation, then you can find the 100 values. Clear? Like I told about the linear transformation, in the linear transformation you can transform your variable over your matrix. You already done this TX. The transformation of Tx is equal to lambda of x, T of x is equal to lambda of x. If your transformation is going through, suppose R3 to R2, and I put the value of lambda is equal to 1, it means that linear transformation over this matrix is equal to Tx is equal to x, or it can be solved by using the matrix determination. Whatever the matrix is 2 by 2, okay, transformation of a matrix through 3 by 3 to 2 by 2. So transformation is dependent upon what type of transformation you already done. Like if you want to rotate a selfie, or you want to rotate a picture, you want to rotate the direction of your vector, then it all can be calculated or can be determined by using the characteristic equation of determinant of A minus lambda I is equal to 0. So this is, we solve by non-trivial solution of Ax is equal to 0. This is your characteristic equation. If I took the determinant of A minus lambda I is equal to 0, then we can calculate this matrix. You can take this exercise over Krasick of chapter 8.1. These all topic are already on the book of Krasick, not in the linear algebra book. So you can take this topic over engineering mathematics, Krasick. You can download it easily, Krasick 9th or 10th edition of chapter 8.1. Okay. So by using the equation, if I take the matrix, if A is minus 2, 2, minus 3, 2, 1, minus 6, minus 1, minus 2 and 0. This is a 3 by 3 matrix, and you have to find your eigenvalues. If first I want to solve this matrix and find the eigenvalues. So what I have to require? I have to require the main characteristic equation that is called A minus a minus lambda I determinant is equal to 0. So if I take the difference of a minus lambda I, you already know what is lambda I? Identity matrix, which is equal to lambda 0, 0, 0, lambda 0, lambda. Okay. So I take the difference of this matrix, minus 2, minus lambda, 2, minus 3, 2, 1, minus 6, minus lambda, minus 1, minus 2, 0, minus lambda. This matrix can be solved by the method of cofactor expansion. So what the value of lambda will become, if I took the determinant of this matrix, I just remove the matrix over determinant. This is your characteristic equation. You can say this is equation number 1. So by using the cofactor expansion, minus 2 minus lambda over 1 minus lambda minus 6 minus 2 minus lambda plus and minus sign minus 2, 2 minus 6 minus 1 and minus lambda, and this will minus 3, 2, 1 minus lambda, minus 1 and minus 2. Is it clear? So by using the cofactor expansion, the value of lambda can be determined. So you have to calculate what is the value of lambda. Anyone? By using the cofactor expansion, you can determine this value. Equation will become by applying the cofactor expansion, minus lambda cube and minus lambda square plus 21 lambda plus 45. This equation must be equal to 0. For finding the value of lambda, you have to put this equation is equal to 0, and this is basically polynomial of which degree? This is called a polynomial. Polynomial of which degree? Degree 3? Or you can say this is a cubic polynomial. So what the method you can determine by solving the cubic polynomial? What you have already done in past, or anyone who can told me what method you have suggest? Divide by lambda cube. Over by using remainder theorem, or you can suppose the supposition method, supposition on behalf of which, like if I took the lambda is equal to 1 and this value, this all polynomial is equal to 0, then this is the root of the equation. So already you all know that what is the synthetic division. Synthetic division is based upon your last constant values. The constant value is 45. If I take the factor of 45, then it will 9 and 5. So instead of taking the value of 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2, you can solve it by using the factor of 45. If I take here 5, by using the method of synthetic division, minus 1, minus 1, 21 and 45, you can write minus 1 as it is and multiply this minus 1 to 5, minus 5, minus 6, multiply minus 6 to 5, minus 30, minus 9, and this is minus 45, and your question solve easily or minimize your time. Okay. Now the next, your equation will become in the form of quadratic equation. Minus 6 lambda minus 9 is equal to 0. By taking minus common, lambda square plus 6 lambda plus 9, and by taking the middle term break, or you can say the formula or whatever, so the equation will become lambda is equal to minus 3 and minus 3. So you can find this value. These are two values which are same. So you have determined only the lambda of 2 is equal to, suppose lambda of 3 is equal to minus 3. So you have to calculate over minus 3 over, because this is the identity, to both eigen values are same. So here, if suppose lambda 1 is equal to 5 and lambda 2 and lambda 3 is equal to minus 3, then you have to solve these eigen values over your eigen vectors. So how can you solve by using the eigen values and eigen vectors? You have to remember your matrix of A minus lambda I. So what is your basic initial matrix? If anyone who told me, can I rub this? So what is your given matrix with lambda? A minus lambda I, what is your matrix?
Minus 2. 2 minus 3, with lambda,
minus 2 minus lambda.
2 minus 3.
2 1 minus lambda.
Minus 6.
Minus 1 minus 2.
0 minus lambda.
This, if I put here lambda is the 1, suppose I want to determine the value of lambda 1, and lambda 1 is equal to 5. So what you can analyze, what's happened with this matrix? It is stretched or it is shrunk? You, by using the picture pixel, what you do? Large or your own passport size. So this pixel can be found by using this characteristic value. Okay. So if A minus lambda I, if I say, so what's happened with this matrix? I ask, is stretch or is it a shrink? What happened?
Matrix shrink.
Because the value will be smaller. So what's the value? -7, 2, -3, 2,
-4,
-6, -1, -2, and -5. Now if we take the value of x, if I multiply by this matrix, throw, how many variables are there? How many variables? How many variables? I told about the variables. How many matrix is 3 by 3? Then variable are also 3 by 3. And it means your variable are x1, x2, x3, or you can say x, y, and z. So if I put this matrix, Ax is equal to 0. I multiply by this matrix of A minus lambda I of x is equal to 0. Then this is -7, 2, -3, 2, -4, -6, -1, -2, -5, x1, x2, and x3. By right hand side should be equal to 0. Then there is 3 by 3 simultaneous equation, you can solve this. So what is the value of x1, x2, and x3 here? What will be the value of x1, x2, and x3? -7 x1 plus 2 x2 minus 3 x3. -7 x1 plus 2 x2 minus 3 x3 is equal to 0. You can say, because the characteristic equation 2x1 minus 4x2 minus 6x3 is equal to 0, 3. Minus x1 minus 2x2 minus 5x3 is equal to 0. If you have to solve this 3 by 3 matrix, oh sorry, 3 by 3 equation, so by taking any values, if I multiply with equation 4 with 2, then this will become only x2 and x3. Multiply this equation by 2. So what's happen here? I directly write 2, 4 and 10 and subtracting 3 from 4. Sorry, adding kya le aap? Then you if you add 3 and 4, then you have minus 8 x2 minus 16 x3 is equal to 0, and you can find minus 8 x2 is equal to 16 x3, and x2 is equal to 2x3. It means there are so many solutions you can find by taking the on basis of the supposition of x3. If I put x3 is equal to 1, then what is the value of x2? If I put in equation number 5, then whatever you can take, but you have to satisfy the value of lambda ax is equal to lambda x. Whatever your values of x, then you have to multiply your original matrix with variable x, and this equation must be satisfied over the value of lambda.
It's equation 3 minus 2x3.
Yes.
X2 is equal to minus 2x3.
This?
Fifth equation.
Minus 2x3. If I take x2 is equal to, x3 is equal to 1, then x2 will be equal to?
Minus 2.
Okay, so by putting the value of x3 and x2 in any equation, suppose in equation number 2, then you can find the value of x1. Value of x3 and x2 in equation number 2. One is I already told of eigen values characteristic equation is your equation 1. So, yes. You have to determine the eigenvalues. I write minus 7. Minus 7 on the basis of your lambda. Your lambda is basically, I took the eigenvector on the basis of the value of lambda 1 is equal to 5. Here, you have to determine by eigenvector on basis of this lambda 1. If I put the value of lambda is equal to minus 5, minus 5, then I ask you what's happened, the matrix is stretch or shrink. Yes. So basically this lambda is told you whatever the matrix will become, or is changed or unchanged, shrink or stretched. Clear? Then if lambda is equal to minus 7, then all our working is there, and putting the value of x3 and x2 in equation number 2, so what will be the value of minus 7 x1 plus 2 minus 2 minus 3 x1 is equal to 0. So what will be the x1? What is the value of x1?
Now let us calculate.
Minus 7 x1 minus 7
minus
7 to 4, minus 4 and minus 3 is equal to 0, and minus 7 x1 is equal to 7, and x1 is equal to 7, minus 7 upon 7, which is equal to minus 1. So you get the x matrix, or you can say for lambda 1, your x1, or x1 means your capital X1, for the value of lambda 1, the value of x1, x2, x3 will be, here I write capital X1 for recognize of the lambda 1, and small x1, x2, x3 is your vector, which you find x1 is minus 1, x2 is minus 2, and x3 is 1. Clear? So you have to solve by taking the proof. How can you say that this on this scalar value the equation is satisfied? How can you say? By using the your value of matrix A multiplied by this matrix of A over X. If the lambda you can find or you can determine, then this is your true value. So you can check on your own basis.
Yes.
किसी भी क्वेश्चन में हम ले सकते हैं, डिपेंड्स अपॉन आप किस से आप साइमल्टेनियसली सॉल्व कर रहे हो. यू हैव टू सॉल्व द साइमल्टेनियस इक्वेशन बाय यूजिंग एनी ट्रिक्स, बाय टेकिंग वन क्वेश्चन वन एंड क्वेश्चन टू, वट एवर यू हैव कैंसिल द टर्म्स बेसिकली, और वट एवर योर कंपटीशन आर इजिली कैन बी सॉल्व. क्लियर? So you have to find the same condition over the lambda is equal to 3 or lambda is equal to minus 3. The lambda 2 and lambda 3 are identical and the value of lambda 2 and lambda 3 is equal to minus 3. So you can take the same exercise and same pattern and you can find the value of x1, x2 and x3. So dear student, if you have any question about this, so you can ask, you want to share. What are? Basically, eigenvalues are your characteristic equation on the basis of your lambda, which is your scalar. This is your scalar quantity. This scalar quantity based upon your equation of your matrix by taking the difference of identity with respect to lambda. If I took A minus lambda I, it means I determine the lambda scalar over identity matrix and find the actual matrix. Is the matrix changed, unchanged, or it's stretched, unstretched, or you can say you can find your electric circuit equation. If electric circuit equation is what's happened with the voltage and with the current, so you can determine by using the value of scalar quantity of lambda.